Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Technic with Sips. Check it out. Check out the progress. Not a lot of progress, unfortunately. Haven't had that much time to play. Not as much time as I would have hoped for. But here's the hole in the ground that I dug last episode. I lived down here for a little while, actually. Look, we got a little turtle down here who's standing on the trapdoor that which leads down into my mines. Got a couple of chests in here still with some valuable stuff that I need to get out of here eventually. I'll be taking this back into my brand spanking new bungalow shortly. When I muster up the courage. No, I'm just joking. I don't need courage. I'm just being lazy. But check out the bungalow. It's still a work in progress. I just put it up quickly so that I could live in it and stop living underground. First couple of nights were interesting with mo creatures. An ogre came by and killed me. Killed me on my first night. I managed to get some wool and I managed to get a bed. I was trying to sleep through it, but when an ogre spawns above your hole in the ground and there's only one square between him and you, if he's thumping around up there, and he catches sniff you, he'll either bust the ground and come down there and kill you himself, or he'll just keep hitting the ground enough to damage you and wake you from your sleep and prevent you from cycling the night into day, which was a pain in the ass. So here we go. We're gonna go in the bungalow, Shay Sips, which is what I've called it. That's like an excellent name for a restaurant. This isn't a restaurant though. This is where I've been living. As you can see, lots of natural light. I also have a glass floor. The idea of the glass floor is to eventually have a lot of pipes piping below my house and bringing me all the stuff that I actually need in the house. A couple of buildings set up over here as well, which I'll explain after. I got my bed, which I've been using, which is pretty good because Technic's got Somnia bundled with it, which is a mod that simulates the world while you're asleep. So it's like being on a server. If you go to sleep and you cycle night into day, when you wake up, stuff that you kicked off before you went to sleep is probably going to be finished because it just simulates all of that. And it's a great mod, actually. So nice addition to a single player Technic here. Which means that I can set some stuff to smelt or whatever overnight, and then when I wake up in the morning, it'll all be done. So that's pretty good. I got this chest here full of stuff. As you can see, I've been pretty busy down in my mine. I got well, not tons of diamond. Got enough diamond to make a pickaxe. Have a couple of spare left over. Made an energy condenser as well. Most importantly, and I made this logger, which required diamonds as well, which I'm planning on using. I was messing around with it a bit at first. Basically, when I first started, I wanted to figure out a good way of getting cheap energy quickly without having to sort of do a lot of mining, get a lot of materials, and go straight into the industrial craft side of energy. I decided that I would start looking into the forestry mod because it's included in the version that I'm using, and you can get some pretty cheap energy through that as well, which I'll go through in a minute. Here's my energy condenser, which I've been using. I got this as soon as I could because basically it just makes your life a lot easier. With equivalent exchange, you can just dump junk in there, and as long as you have a copy of an item that you want to make, you can turn that junk into something useful. I've got two crafting tables. I got a Mark II here for stuff that I have the mats for, and because for some reason I can't actually search recipes for stuff, I just got this other crafting table here because I've got the search bar here. As you can see, I was looking up how to make bog earth, which I don't actually need to know how to make now, because I know how to. And as I said, as long as you have the materials, you can go into the crafting table too, and it'll tell you what you can build based on what's actually in your inventory. So that's pretty cool. So back to energy, build craft energy. Build craft energy is all based around engines, and is different energy to what is in industrial craft, I found out. So industrial craft is things like your generators, your geothermal generators, solar panels, windmills, all that kind of stuff is considered industrial craft. Oh my God, did you hear that? There's some real rumbling out there, and I don't know what's going on. It's either werewolves, could be an ogre, or something else. God, I don't know. I'm gonna go to sleep and hope that all this stuff goes away. So I'll see you in a second. What a night. Bit sweaty. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a bit sweaty. Those were a lot of moanings and groanings and rumblings coming from outside. Look at that. I think that's a ghost. God, Mo Creatures is pretty cool, but at the same time quite terrifying. Nighttime just takes on a whole new meaning with Mo Creatures installed in single player. You really do have to do a lot of fighting for your life. So as I was saying before, I'm gonna make my way over to these buildings while I'm telling you about the differences between buildcraft power and industrial craft power. As I was saying, buildcraft is all engine based and based around buildcraft engines, and industrial craft power is all based around the machines that you build in the. Oh my God, there we go. No damage, thank God. Look at these blue creepers. Get out of here, blue creeper. Come on. But the only diff well. Not difference. The problem is that you can't easily. Well, there are ways of converting build craft energy into industrial craft energy and vice versa. And luckily, because I'm on an older version, well, and or not the dev version, should I say, of Technic, I've still got the forestry mod. And through the forestry mod, you get something called an electric engine. Now, an electric engine you can use to convert your build craft energy. Or your industrial craft energy. So if you wanted to, you could use like something like a bat box from industrial craft that's full of industrial craft energy. Pipe that to the electrical engine or wire it to the electrical engine with like some copper wires or something like that. And that would give in energy to the electric engine, and the electric engine would then produce buildcraft energy so that it could power some of these buildcraft machines that we're about to see in here. This, by the way, is my peat bog. I set up a peat bog and I've really been enjoying the forestry mod. I gotta say, it is a great mod. It's a great addition to Technic, and I really hope that they include it in version 7 of Technic, which is still in development at the moment. Basically, a peat bog is what is going to power all of my early machines for the early game of my sort of playthrough of Technic. So for a peat bog, you got a peat bog generator, which at the moment is being powered by a peat-fired engine, which I created. When I first created this peat bog, I created it with steam engines because I didn't have any fuel for these peat-fired engines. But of course, once the peat bog was up and I started harvesting peat, I could then use it for these peat-fired engines. And they produce as much energy as a steam engine, which is pretty cool. The only difference, obviously, with the steam engine is that it uses coal for fuel. And coal is something that's quite expensive to create in the energy condenser and a bit of a pain in the ass to go mine manually. So for me, peat-fired engines are a great alternative because I can create tons of peat with this peat bog. In fact, one of these peat bogs can create enough peat bars to power 10 of these peat-fired engines, which is great. I mean, I could power a quarry with that kind of energy. Anything in Buildcraft, basically, I could power decently with this sort of renewable source of fuel and energy. So that's excellent. I've also got this machine here, which is called a turbary. And turbary is what's actually harvesting all of this bog earth. You probably saw before when I was looking at the crafting table, I had bog earth looked up because I wanted to see the recipe. Bog earth is something that you can craft yourself. You just need a bit of dirt, a bit of sand, and a water bucket. And basically, once you've created some bog earth, and I've got a little bit here which I can show you come over to this peat bog generator. You dump it into the input. See, it's using it already. And basically, what that's doing is it's replacing some of these dirt blogs, blogs? Blocks with the bog earth. The bog earth then sits there and matures and gets to a point where it can then be harvested by the turbary, and the turbary then turns that into these peat pellets here. I call them pellets, but they're bars. They're just bars of peat, and stores them within the machine. Now, what we're going to do today is we're going to pipe all of those bars out of these machines and into this little building over here. Which is sort of like my assembly point for all the agricultural stuff I'm going to be doing. Once I have enough of these peat bars, I'm going to have a ton of fuel that I can use for peat-fired engines, and I'm going to be able to power some more stuff in forestry. I definitely want to get a tree farm set up next because I just think it's so cool to have a farm that keeps regrowing trees, chopping them down, and sending the wood back to my house so that I can build other cool stuff, like maybe some sort of tower or like an elevator up to the Skylab that I'm planning on building, or anything else, basically. So I've got all the pipes that I need. I'm just gonna close the door in case in case it gets dark and stuff starts trying to break in and kill me. I'm gonna have to go make some more bog earth after, but there's more than enough peat stored in there to start piping it. So I've got a combination of pipes at the moment. I've got some cobblestone pipes, and I've got some stone pipes as well. Now, stone pipes I don't need too many of, but I just want to get them so that I can have stone pipe coming out of one side here, and then I can have cobblestone on the other. And see, these won't link up because they're different types of pipes. So we can carry this on down here and down here. And basically, I'm going to do the same over here. I want to get, and you'll notice I'm hooking these up to an engine. That's a crucial part, actually, and I forgot to mention that. These peat-fired engines use peat bricks or peat bars as their fuel. And their byproduct is ash. Now, this ash is really useful for us as well because the ash is a component that's used in creating humus. And humus, in conjunction with saplings, is what you need to fuel or, well, fuel a tree farm. So those are the two inputs that that a tree farm needs in order to start actually planting and growing the trees. And then if you combine that with a logger, the logger will then wait for the trees to be grown, chop them down, and then you can do the exact same thing that we're doing here right now. You can pipe everything out off to a storage facility or back to your house. So that's pretty cool. That's why I'm hooking up these pipes to the engine and also the machine. Now, you only need to. Oh, actually, it doesn't seem to be working for some reason. I think I might need to do it on the side, which is a bit of a pain in the ass. You don't need any sort of you don't need like a wooden transport pipe or anything for these, but you do need to have them on the side, which is a bit of a pain in the ass. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just get them down this side because I don't want them too close to the other side. What I'm going to do is all four pipes are going to come down and join on an iron pipe so that everything that hits that junction, the connection of the four pipes, will have to go one way through that iron pipe. Iron pipes are one way anyway, so. So once this stuff starts coming out of the side, so we'll get a cobblestone and we'll get a stone pipe there. And we'll bring that down. I'm gonna head down here. As soon as we've hooked this up to the side of the machine and the engine, anything that's inside it will start coming out. For the peat bog generator, this dirt will start coming out, which, you know, we can just pipe straight back to the house. Eventually, and then shove it right into the energy condenser and start using that to condense stuff, or create stuff out of trash, as they say in the industry. I'll also get the same sort of thing set up over here, so I'm gonna have to, for now, get rid of that and place it somewhere else, probably just below it, which should be fine. Where did it go? Here it is. See, I got a couple of these peat-fired engines here. See, I'm thinking ahead. I'm ready to go. So power that back up. We'll get our pipes ready. So we got cobblestone here, and let's get stone here. I don't want to hook them up directly straight away though, because I don't want stuff to start coming down straight away and just dumping onto the floor, because then I'll have to put it in my inventory. I'm running out of space in my inventory. So let's make the tunnel back here somewhere so that if I ever need to come down here and do some maintenance, I can actually do that. So start digging here. Just dig out roughly to where we need to go. Oops. There we go. We've exposed the outside, but we can cover the pipes up after. I'm just digging the trench for now, just to get it underneath here. A bit more digging. Oh, this is thrilling, isn't it? Watching a guy dig in Minecraft. Fantastic. So here we go. We'll get in under here, and then we should be able to break into the chest that's under there. But that's fine. We'll come back and do that in a minute. So this is all going to be cobblestone, and then we're going to connect it all with an iron pipe. And we're probably going to do it this way. So we're gonna have to go. I'm gonna need to get in there actually. And this is where it gets fun. This is where it gets really fun with pipes. God, you gotta love pipes. Okay, let's get the iron transport pipe set up around. I guess we could set it up. I want it to be here though, so that I can make use of all the many inputs as I can. That's fine. I'll put it right there for now. And I've got my wrench. Oh, by the way, yeah, if you're using iron pipes, you need one of these wrenches. I've got both types of wrench. I got this wrench that I made with bronze bars, after macerating up some copper and some tin, and creating bronze bars. And these are to use. This is what you can bust your industrial craft engines with without losing all the components. This other wrench, I can't remember what I used to make it, but it's basically like a build craft wrench. And you can use that to readjust the iron pipes, so you can pick where the output goes and all that kind of stuff. So I'm just gonna dig along the side here because I need access to this. And here we go. This is all gonna be cobblestone down here, so I should be able to get in there after and just pipe all the way. Let's get the stone pipes set up to run down here, and this is stone. So I've got stone and cobblestone pipes, right? So here we go. Got cobblestone pipe down here. We don't want the cobblestone ones to connect, and we don't want the stone ones to connect. So it can get a little bit tricky. Look, I don't even have room to jump over the pipes and stuff. Okay, I'll be back in a second, and this will all be sorted out. I won't torture you any longer with my pipe trying to figure out the pipes. Okay, I'm back. I think this is gonna work, and it's a real mess down there, so get ready. But we're gonna hook everything up, and we're gonna see if it works. So here we go. We're gonna hook this up. We're gonna also hook this up, and there we go. We got some dirt coming out of the pipe straight away. I hope that's the right one. Is that the right one? That's the right one. There it goes. There goes all the dirt. That coming out the side. Oh my god, I think it might be the other side. That's okay though. Let's try this anyway. Stone and cobblestone. Oh, look at all the peat. Oh, there's all the peat. Fantastic. Now, it's gonna come down here. Oh gosh, what a mess. Get down into this trench. Look, I've got little ladders and everything, and another little trench down here. And let's just see, is it gonna come through here? It looks like it might. Here comes some dirt. Here comes some more dirt. Did the dirt make it? Oh. Oh no, that one's wrong. Hang on. We'll fix that. Oh, there we go. That should be it. Just a couple of hits with the wrench. And oh god, there's a big stack of dirt coming through here. So we're gonna try to pipe this up. And I don't want this stuff to go into my inventory if I can help it. Is it gonna come through here? Oh yeah, it's coming through. Fantastic. The pipes have worked. Okay, great. So let's continue to pipe all this. Is it coming down the right way? Is it coming down? Oh yeah, it's coming towards me. And look, here comes all the peat bars too. Oh, fantastic. God, I love pipes. I love pipes. The messier the pipes, the better for me too. God, I love messy pipes. It's raining and it's dark outside, so I need to be somewhat careful. Oh my god, is that a wolf? Get out of here, wolf. Come on. What are you doing? Got some scorpions. What else is out here? Anything? Nothing. Fantastic. Carry on building some pipes. Oh yeah. God, this is the life. Working outside in the rain, making things work. Oh yeah. Okay, so let's dig into here and let's see where the chest is. It's over here. We can replace all this stuff after, though. It's fine. So it's gonna come in here, and that should be fine. It'll pipe up like this. So more pipe, and we'll go out and refill the ground and stuff after. Hopefully everything is merrily making its way down here. And we could put some gold pipes on there too, to speed things up. But for now, it's a blockage. Is there any blockage? No, it's just going slow as all goddamn hell. But that's fine. That's fine for now. Let's just make sure that it's connected up to the chest, which seems to be. The chest is empty. Oh boy. Fantastic. So I'm just gonna replace all this here. And everything is now piping out of the peat bog, which is great. I'm just sort of shuffling around in my inventory here because I want to put the dirt back on here because I don't want to see the pipes necessarily. And as you can see, everything's making its way down, so it's going to end up in the chest shortly. There's a rat in the way. Come on, rat. Come on, more creatures. Why you got to bust my balls when I'm trying to lay some pipe? Seriously. And there we go. All nice and hidden. We can go back in here and make sure that everything is coming out where it needs to. It doesn't look like the ash is coming out for some reason. Maybe it's on the wrong side. Oh, and that's some dirt that went back up the way. But look at that. We got some peat bars making their way merrily through this goddamn mess of pipes under here. But luckily I built these trenches so that if I ever need to do some maintenance, I can get down here. Look, I got an iron pipe here to pipe all this stuff and to join these cobblestone pipes together without stuff going back up to where they came from. And then that junction, that sort of crucial junction over here, which sort of funnels everything into here, sends it down there. And oh my god, I think we need some... I forgot to put some torches up. I should have really put some torches. I hope nothing spawns down there. I don't think anything can fit. Maybe just rats. Ugh, God. I don't want to see any rats. But there we go. So now I'm collecting all of the fuel that I need for my peat-fired engines, and which means that I can make some more peat-fired engines. I'm going to need some more bog earth. Look at this. It's all going to hell up here. I'm going to go make some in a minute, though. I can make my peat-fired engines power just about anything now. But I think what I'm going to do next is get a tree farm set up. So I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you learned a little bit about peat bogs and ghosts. Oh my god, I can't believe this ghost is just trying to attack me on my own turf. Sorry, like I was saying, I hope you learned a little bit about peat bogs. I hope you learned a bit about energy, buildcraft energy, and sort of sustainable and renewable fuel and energy. And I hope you also learned how bad I am at putting pipe systems together. But, like I said, I love messy pipe systems. And actually, I don't even like burying pipes underground. I wish I just had just a mess of pipes to look at all the time so I could see all the cool stuff going through it and ending up in the places that they need to end up in. So, as usual, thanks for watching. I hope you're impressed with my progress. I'm pretty impressed, considering. I mean, I haven't played that much, but I've got a couple of things set up. I think next we're going to get the forester set up, and then shortly after that, probably a quarry. So stay tuned for more, and I'll catch you next time.